Hey, what's up, guys? Today is day one of my trip down in Kenya. I'm about to meet up with my sponsored children today, and just got out of bed. It's a beautiful day here in Kenya. Thought it was going to be totally raining and pouring, but I guess not. No, it's actually really nice right now. I'm going to get out of bed here, and we'll go ahead and get this show on the road. And see how it goes. Tonight, she hears only whispers of some quiet conversation. She's coming in 12:30 flight. The moonlit wings reflect the stars that guide me towards salvation. I stopped an old man along the way. I'm in the car right now with my sponsor children. This is Steven. Say hello.
Hey, he's a little shy,
but we're about to go ahead. We're heading out here and we're about to do what we're doing next, and I'll see you guys in a little bit.
Dogs cry out in the night as they grow restless, longing for some solitary company. I know that I must do what's right, sure as Kilimanjaro rises like Olympus above the Serengeti. I seek to cure what's deep inside, frightened of this thing that I've become.
We're here at the Mamba village. Mamba means crocodile, so we're at a crocodile village right now. And we're just starting our tour. And there is indeed two crocodiles right over there. And oh wow, and there's a whole bunch. I've never actually seen a crocodile up close either. So do they always just, when I look at them, they look like they're statues? And they don't. Are they sleeping?
Yes. Oh, hello. Yes, we want to be giving the crocodile. Yes, yeah. We are going to be giving the crocodile. Yes, we are going to be giving the crocodile. Yes, we are going to be giving the crocodile. Yes, we are going to
be giving
the crocodile. Yes, we are all alive.
Oh, okay. Yeah, I was looking at them like.
But they pretend to be dead. I'm looking for the oldest. Where is she? There. That's the oldest.
Olden one and farthest away in the water?
Yes, the mother.
Oh, okay.
But there's one here, we are expecting her to lay eggs very soon. She's over there. Simno, you're a crocodile. Oh, senior, Simno, you're a crocodile. And you're here. I'm here to see you. I'm here to see you. No shoes. Come here, wiki for you.
All right.
And you want to wiki one of these people. You want to know Limmy? Is he going to know Limmy?
Sorry, I got it right in your way.
I want to. This, but she's not the one with the eggs. She's the one.
Oh, they're making that sound.
Warning sound. Sasa angalia, look. Atiko tiko, tuguza guza hivi haja.
It's like, oh man, you just woke me up. I had this really awesome dream. Do they have like a their age and like a, is there such thing as crocodile years?
Yeah, we have them. Yes, we have, but tears no.
Oh, okay.
Yes, if you are, let's say like him, he's telling her, I can see your crocodile tears. It means she's faking the tears.
Oh.
Because there's none. You can see. Angalia, sinona. Haina machozi. Eh. All that is the warning sound. And here, five toes. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5.
Oh, okay.
But on the back it is 4. Those ones there.
This is probably a really silly question. Yeah? Do their teeth like break off and
they
then regrow?
There's a guy in the famous guy from Australia. Mm-hmm. I think he reached 4,000 sets.
Oh, gee. 4,000 sets of teeth? Okay.
It's like this year, that tooth was maybe having almost 100 times coming out. Like in 1 year, he was finding that there was a crocodile. Like this tooth here, this one here. It broke. In 3 days, another one came out. Another 3 days.
Oh, wow.
Like that. And there's a sound they can make. Like this one.
He looks like he wants, that one right there looks like he wants to eat me.
Oh, this one?
Yeah, he's just sitting there. Oh, jeez.
That's the sound.
Oh, there you go.
There's a sound they make when it is hot. Closing the mouth and then you hear, pop.
Uh-huh.
But right now, because it is cold, they cannot snap. In your country, do you have crocodiles?
Yes. Not in Washington State where I'm from. We have some in... most of the crocodiles that are native are like down in Louisiana and down by the south.
Yes, Louisiana, Florida, New Orleans.
Yeah, that area.
Freshwater crocodile and the, but most is the alligators.
Yeah.
So the difference between this and alligator
yes,
is their mouth.
Yeah.
V, U.S. is U. They close the mouth, they shut the mouth, you see all the teeth. U.S. you don't see. So that we lost that crocodile. In the water, we have lost him.
Like he's dead? Or?
No, he's alive, but
oh,
he has a broken right leg. This leg that you can see, it is broken. And the tip of the tail is also broken. Kujo wana guka. Wanda kuna guka. Ewu guka apa. Kujo wana guka. Ati? Let's talk to apa.
Who disturbs me from my slumber? I was having this really awesome dream. Imagine how infuriating that's got to be for the turtle. You get stuck like that and you're like, oh, I can't move. This like this tour is like going like a tour around the whole continent.
Yes, we call it 11.
Okay. Have they ever tried cotton candy? But no. Oh, this is a real treat then. I tried. I don't really care for it, but it's. Do they know what to do with it? Even? Wait, let me see. Oh, he's got it. It's a little bit messy. You kind of have to grab a little chunk of it. Oh, look at that. I have no idea. What is it? Is that chicken?
Yeah.
Wow.
Yeah, like your mama.
Okay. Very cool. More. And the chips. Oh, there you go. Let me try one. Wow, that's good. Really is, yes. I have a friend of mine, he's huge into fried chicken, just chicken. He would totally be going buck wild right about now. Huge fried chicken fan. Oh, there you go. All right, so I could be exchanged gifts, and Senpai over here made for me a necklace, or no, excuse me, not a necklace, a bracelet. What's this design? Do you know?
I'm not sure.
I don't know what that design is, but she also gave me a another bracelet. It definitely can't fit around my hand at all. But it just barely fits on my fingers, but it's supposed to go down here. And she made this for me, has my name on it, as you can see, in sort of the US, USA colors. And then she also made this for me. It's a necklace of the Kenya symbol on it. And I also have this really awesome belt. I can definitely wear this. This is gonna go right around like this. Around this way. Just like that. Check that out, isn't that awesome? Look at that. Look at the detail that went into that. Look at it. That's really cool. So anyways, we're headed out to the Giraffe Park right now. To which we will take more pictures and show you more fun.
Say cheese! Smile!
Seen a giraffe. I'm walking up to the giraffe right now. Oh my gosh. Can we feed it?
Yeah.
I don't have any food. Like, where did... Oh my gosh. Look how tall that thing is. Oh my gosh. Can we feed it? Oh, it's up there. Okay. Oops. Oh, there you go. Oh, ew. Holy cow. How tall is this giraffe? Like 10 feet tall? Oh, that's how you do it. Oh, she knows exactly what she's doing. Here you go. Ah, ew. I don't think I'm going to want to try that. Oh. Holy comes another one. Oh, wow.
Ah, that's good.
Oh, yeah, I've seen that. Mr. Giraffe. I shall call you Jeffrey. You're my Jeffrey.
He's a real...
This one over here.
Oh, there you go. Little one.
Oh, mini Jeffrey. Oh, there you go. I'm trying to get the little one. Here, little one. Little Jeffrey. Oh, by the way, there's Pumbaa down there. Does he eat giraffe food? Let me see. Yep. Oh, there you go. Yeah, he eats that. Gotta fly now. Whoop. Funny back there. What are you laughing at?
So I just met with my sponsored children yesterday, and it's lots of fun. We saw a lot of animals, and I finally got to see a giraffe. I was really excited about that just before I came here. I told myself, you know what? I vow that I will not leave Kenya until I see a giraffe. And I saw a giraffe, so I'm really excited about that. But what I wanted to do now is I wanted to take a few moments and kind of talk to you guys a little bit about what I do. And hopefully you can see me. I couldn't get my lighting to work this morning. For some reason it was working for a little bit and then it decided to cut out on me. But I wanted to take a few moments and kind of tell you a little bit about what I do as a sponsor and kind of like what I've done throughout the years. So Compassion International, who I sponsor through, is an agency a lot like World Vision that helps children around the world overseas. They're based out of Colorado Springs, and through them I sponsor both my children, both of which I started about 4 years ago. And to kind of give you a little bit of backstory, there was a time when I had lost my car that I had at the time. I used to drive a Ford Mustang GT, and I had lost it. I had to get rid of it due to financial reasons. So there was a time when I had a little bit of extra money to kind of not play with, I guess, per se, but to, you know, do something with it positive, just, you know, save it up. I even saved up so much money. In fact, I actually went on a cruise at the time, and there was a time when I didn't have a car for 2 years, and but I still had everything else I needed. I was still doing pretty good. But I say all that to say that I wanted to do something where I, even though I had taken a huge financial hit, I still wanted to, I had this desire to help somebody overseas, and I had done another kind of something similar through Compassion. I heard about them through a local radio station, and if you're from the Seattle-Tacoma area, I think they're actually all over the U.S., but there was a radio station called Air One. It's 88.1 if you're in the Seattle-Tacoma area, but I originally learned about them through that radio station, and I decided, why not give them a try? I know like World Vision is kind of like the more obvious place that most people think of, but I wanted to try them out, and so I did this thing where they had sort of a campaign where you could, if you wanted to help children at least temporarily, you know, to get them clean water, clean food, even if you were a sponsor, you could send. I don't think it was a whole lot of money. I think it was like maybe $50. And he's like, you know, if you want to help, send X amount of dollars. And I did. And I kind of just left it at that for a while. But then I decided, I think I really want to sponsor a child. I'd worked at, or served rather, at my church, Champion Center in Tacoma, Washington, through kids ministry, mostly on the worship team, but I had done other things like kids camp and other things like that. I'd been serving in kids ministry for pretty much as long as I can remember. I remember I first started playing guitar when I was 14. I had played guitar, I think for maybe a couple months. I still played, but then once I turned 15, that's when I started playing bass guitar, and that's what I've been playing ever since. So for those of you that have seen me play or on the worship team at church, for those of you that are, you know, watching this video right now, you've seen me play before, most likely. And that's what I did, and I had also served in junior high and high school, and even main platform a few times, and I used to go to another church called Cornerstone Community Baptist off of Military Road in Kent. But I had been affiliated with serving in kids ministry for a long time, so I thought, well, why not sponsor a child? And for some reason, I just felt like I really wanted to sponsor a child from Kenya. No, I'm not really sure why exactly. Kenya was just, after praying about it for some time, Kenya was just sort of the country that kind of just came to mind after praying about it. But I say all that to say that I had also never had children of my own. And so I thought, like, well, what better opportunity to sponsor one boy, one girl, overseas, both in Kenya, and they'd be sort of like my surrogate children that I never had. So that was the reason why I kind of wanted to do that. And for some reason, just Kenya just was the country that came to mind. So right around June 2015, that's when I finally decided to finally take that step and sponsor my first child. And I think about maybe a month or two later, that's when I sponsored my second child as well. So. Their names are Senpai and Steven, as you saw earlier. But what I wanted to take a moment and give you a couple of verses. I really want to inspire more people to sponsor children overseas. But in Kenya specifically, a lot of the families that live in Kenya have to deal with I think it's like 65% unemployment, and that's mainly due to low education. And many of the children over there, as well as
other families over there have to deal with a lot of homes, typically with a small crude construction made from local materials. As you saw earlier, we passed by a street where a lot of the buildings were made out of poor products. A lot of the more arid places in the arid south specifically have stick frames covered with cow dung in a lot of places, and not very many people have access to water or proper sanitation. And there are ways where you, the viewer, can help a child that lives in one of these situations. A lot of these places, they deal with malnutrition. They can't afford medical help. Some of the areas that my two sponsored children came out of deal with HIV infected areas. And a lot of the children that do make it through the Kenya educational system, typically classrooms are 80 students per teacher and have poor quality education. Parents are unable to pay the required fees for books, supplies, and other things. And there's a whole list of other problems just due to life and education and other things. I'm not going to get into all of that right now. If you sponsor a child, and you don't necessarily have to use Compassion International if you don't want to. There's other agencies like Compassion, such as World Vision, that you could sponsor a child through. How Compassion International works is Compassion began working in Kenya in 1980. Currently, more than 98,200 children are registered in 376 child development centers. Most children attend the center for 14 hours per week. Kenya also has 240 students in the leadership development program, and 1,878 mothers and their babies serve through the child survival program. So your sponsorship can help one of these children, and they can go through this program. And you can do this all for about $35 a month. I know this sounds very cliche, but just two of your, let's say you buy a $5 coffee every day before going to work, just two of those coffees per week can sponsor one child overseas. So what I wanted to do now, I want to share a couple of verses with you. This first one, oh, and by the way, I don't know, you've probably never heard this Bible before. I read out of what's called the Hallelujah Scriptures. It's basically a Bible that focuses on Hebraic restored names. Not just names of people, but the names of places. And the reason why that's important, because names actually mean something. So, for instance, our first passage that we're going to look at is in the book of Lucas, or Luke, chapter 9, starting in verse 46. And a reasoning arose among them who might be greater of them. And Yeshua, meaning Jesus, having seen the reasoning of their heart, took a little child and placed him by his side. And he said to them, "Whoever receives this child in my name receives me, and whoever receives me receives him who sent me. For he who is least among you, he shall be great." So Jesus is basically saying here, for what you've done for the least of these, you've done for me. So by sponsoring a child overseas, what you're basically doing is you're reflecting Christ in a very positive way. The next passage I want to also look at is in Matithyahu, that is Matthew, chapter 6, starting at verse 25. Because of this, I say to you, do not worry about your life, what you shall eat or drink, or about your body, what you shall put on. Is not life more than the food, and the body more than clothing? Look at the birds of the Shemaim, that means heaven. For they neither sow nor reap nor gather into storehouses, yet your Father in the Shemaim feeds them. Are you not worth more than they? And which of you, by worrying, is able to add one pikas, that basically means hour, to his life's span? So why do you worry about clothing? Note well the lilies of the field, how they grow, they neither toil nor spin. And I say to you that even Solomon, can't pronounce it very well, I think it's in all the esteem was not dressed like one of these. But if Elohim so clothes the grass of the field, which exists today and tomorrow is thrown in the furnace, do not worry then, saying what you shall eat, or what you shall drink, or what you shall wear. For these the Gentiles seek for, and your Father in the Shemaim knows that you need all these. And this next verse is the most important part that I wanted to get to. Verse 33. But seek first the reign of Elohim and his righteousness, and all these shall be added unto you. I think most people understand that other translations say basically, seek first the kingdom of God and all these things. And by things, I mean like, you know, like I mentioned before, you know, basic needs, clothing, food, shelter, transport, maybe like if, you know, car, driving a car to work, and many others. Bible says here that when you focus on seeking first the kingdom of Elohim, or what we understand is God, all these things, the personal things that you need in your life will come to you, not the other way around. So with that being said, I just want to wrap up this part of the video and encourage every single one of you to sponsor a child. It's my belief that by doing this, you'll really actually be helping yourself. And ever since I've sponsored a child, two children through Compassion International 4 years ago, I've really been doing it for me. Not because I want to try to make myself look great, or try to puff myself up in my own estimation, but by helping other children, you're really helping yourself. So that's why I encourage every single person watching this to sponsor a child. The point is to just start sponsoring someone. And I'm going to leave a link below in the description if you want to learn more about Compassion and what they do, and more about where they sponsor and how you can get started sponsoring a child today. So other than that, I'm going to go ahead and finish getting dressed here. I was going to go on a few adventures. I was going to check out the Nairobi National Park today and check out some animals, go on a few tours. I'm going to go ahead and get going here, and we'll take it away.